I would now like to introduce the next of our speakers, which is Dr. Errol Noel. He's professor of engineering at Howard University.
Well, good afternoon and welcome to all. My name is Dr. Noel. I'm a faculty at Howard University. My profession is transportation engineering. I'm also a faculty of the Department of Civil Engineering. You're on the verge of making a choice. Where do I go to school? Where do I do this, that, and the other? Or whether I choose engineering? Based on the information disseminated to you by the modal administrations, I think you have a reason why engineering is a good bet. There may be those of you who may not be interested in engineering and may have made that decision. It's not engineering. But fortunately, the field of transportation is broad enough that it has room for all of us. So if you're interested in the social science, we have room for you. If you're interested in business, we have room for you. If you're interested in law, oh yes, you too can come along. We have room for anything that a university can produce. So we can meet up later on, you as the social scientist and I as the engineer. Because the problems we face today are multilateral, multidimensional, and very often, no single field has the complete solution. We need all of us to work together on that. Now, coming from Howard University, you can find all that information about Howard University on the website. You can go in there and get into my department, see my name and the names of others, and you can see the various program structures, soil mechanics, and so on that we offer. But what I want to talk to you today is about that decision that you're about to make. You're about to leave high school, therefore you should have the preparation to get into a university or to pursue whatever you identify as your next step. For engineering, we cannot escape it. Math, science, physics, chemistry, and something that is becoming not so important because of the social media, English. We are having a problem coming with English. Everything is not just two lines and make up your own spelling. We have a challenge to work with that in high school, and when you go to university, I hope you find one that would actually help you work on that. We have to write the reports, we have to speak in the public, we have to talk about our projects. Social media is not really helping us too much in that regard, and I hope you recognize that. So when it comes to the mathematics, science, physics, chemistry, be ready. But as I know, as being a chair for the department for 10 years, there will be those of you who are what? Not quite ready. But we have hope for you. Summer school, take advantage of that. Community colleges, take advantage of that. So when you get on board, assuming you start in fall, you really should be ready to swim with the sharks. Now, in terms of selecting engineering, I strongly recommend that you do your homework. Your guidance counselor will not do all the homework for you, nor do your parents. Fortunately, we have the World Wide Web. And it's not just for browsing into the social area. It's a global library. Everything is there. Educate yourself. Find out about the 20-something fields in engineering. Know what they are. Once you know that, you're in a better position to do what? Focus on the few or the one that you might be interested in. But just don't blindly select civil engineering because Noel is a civil engineer. Or my neighbor is a mechanical engineer, therefore my neighbor, or even therefore my parent is an engineer, therefore I do that too. Because they won't be with you on the journey when you graduate, and we have to like what we do. And there's a good opportunity to do that in all the fields of engineering. Once you decided on a specific field or you express or you seem to have some interest, don't just chill. Delve deeper. If your parents don't have the background, we have professional societies. All of them that I know of are willing to entertain questions from high school kids. American Society of Engineers, the Institute of Transportation Engineering. I know they do these things. And of course, you have a school that is close to you, pay a visit. If I were chair of civil engineering, I would welcome a visit from you. Let's talk about engineering. Not with the intent of making you a civil engineer, but we as adults, we have to promote the interests of young adults in doing something positive with their lives. When I was chair, I had students calling me from all over the country. No commitment to come to Howard University. But the fact that they're thinking positively, that was the encouragement for me to keep on having a conversation with them. Before you commit to an institution, I want you to remember the academic preparations, that's taken for granted. You would have it. But the environment on the campus, the culture on the campus, the support system that you need when you get to that campus, please check it out. It's easy to come in and you get scholarship to start. I've seen that all the time. But it's not just starting, we have to finish. And we have to sustain that grade point average that is necessary for saving your parents so you money. The grade point average that is the preparation for you to go to graduate school, if you so decide. And the grade point average that will make you are very selective when the employers visit. Oh yes, they visit the campus. They come to check you out. They provide the opportunity for you to interact and talk. But that grade point average is important. And lastly, what I would like to say, visit the schools. You can't visit all. There are good schools all over America. And the one thing I would say about engineering is, we do have a standard. We do have an accreditation board that accredits all universities that have engineering programs. It's called ABET. Therefore, we all have a standard that we must have at all universities. If we have that, then what becomes the main issue is whether you choose the university that fits your fits the background that you have, such that when you go there, you feel that you're in a culture in which you can thrive. That you would not see on websites. That you may not get from your guidance counselors. So when you make that visit, pay attention to that. Apart from the preparation that you would have, summer is coming up, and there's an opportunity to do a lot of things during summer. Search the web for activities that may be near to you. There are universities that are engaging even high school kids in research. You might want to think about that. Those of you may have deficiencies that you like to catch up on. Sometimes it's physics and the mathematics and so on. Take advantage of the community college, or if your high school has some sort of extended program to accommodate you, take advantage of that. The first 2 years are going to be all about physics, chemistry, mathematics. Expect to find commitment in that area for the first 2 years. What you would try not to do is to be in a remedial status when you get to university, such that you're doing high school math, but you're on a university campus. Some of you may have to make a little sacrifice, avoid the urge to just find a job to get some pocket change, and deprive yourself of the preparation such that you can swim with all other students once you start the first semester. College life is not intimidating. It's just that you have to be prepared. College life requires a sacrifice, and it requires you giving your best, especially if you're in any field that has to do with science, mathematics, technology, and engineering. And of course, at the end of that four-year journey, there is the reward. You find yourself a career that you can take to the rest of your life. I never had to look for a job as a civil engineer. I had jobs to choose. As bad as the economy is right now, I still have jobs to choose. Why? The demand is there. It's a career decision that you're about to make, and don't take it lightly. Listen to your parents, listen to your neighbors, listen to your guidance counselor, but you have some homework to do. Thank you very much.